3, 2, 1.
I've opened myself up there, haven't I?
Just having a thing.
Love the shirt. From Park.
It's what you all wanted to hear. The 2024 Vitality Blast season starts now. I'm Max Whittle. Welcome to our brand new show, Friday Night Blast. We'll be with you every week with exclusive interviews, fan features, and the best of the action.
Oh, wow, that's absolutely awesome.
All together.
Come on, Carmen!
Yeah. Bond, wait.
Oh, yes!
We begin today's show here in Bristol, home of Banksy and a couple of other well-known artists.
This is Friday Night Blast.
Good to see you back.
So, thank you.
How are you feeling?
All good.
Yeah?
Can't wait.
We were just in town and I compared you two to Banksy, the artist. That's art.
Thank you.
For you?
That is art. That is art.
Wall art around the Bristol. He paints it.
What wall art do you know? It's shocking. Since when are you into your art? All right, and you, I find out every day something new.
The only piece of art I'm looking at is his moustache.
That's what he said.
It looks a little bit different this year.
Oh, it does, yeah. But overgrown than normal.
Do you think it's the best kept player in the blast?
Oh, bless you, Graham. He's got to say it. Why are you making me blush, Graham?
I'm trying to remember this now from our South African cam op. Who hat dit?
Who han dit?
Yes.
I didn't nail it then, did I?
Yeah, you did. You did. Who han dit?
Give it me one more time.
Who han dit?
Who han dit?
Yeah. Baie goed, dankie.
Lekker.
That's the word. Yeah. That's the word. And very good.
I want to give one of you a hug or both.
Yeah, give him a hug. He's a hugger.
Well, get in there. Right.
Really? Graham?
Big bull tongue.
The big bull tongue.
I love that.
Yeah.
Mark, the blast is back.
Yes.
Excited?
Yeah, very much so. You know, we had the first 8 weeks of the season. We had a gluttony of four-day cricket, which we did quite well in. Time to change the tempo, have a little fun, and see if we can compete and win some games.
This is Mr. Gloucester. Mm. Do you remember your first day associated with this club?
I do, yeah, quite vividly. In fact, my very first day, I walked out onto the pitch. I didn't know the players. Mm. I was introduced the morning of the game, but to people that I knew of course. But I couldn't believe I was standing on the same pitch as them. I remember watching Dave Lawrence running in, first ball of the game. I thought, gosh, that's a long run, and ooh, that's quite quick. But yeah, no, good place, loved every minute of it.
2003, do you remember your first blast memories?
I do. It was here, the Worcestershire. And I remember at the time, everyone thought it was going to be a bit of a hit and a giggle. I remember Worcestershire had, I think their normal number 10 and 11 were promoted to open the batting just to go and have a go. Matt Mason, I remember distinctly because I bowled a maiden to him in our first blast game here. And he was just swinging and missing. But it's evolved, I would say, a little bit since then.
What does Gloucester mean to you?
Well, it's a big part of my life. You know, I came here in 86, played for 20 years, and now coaching. So a big part of my working life is all Gloucestershire. I very much like everything about the club here in Bristol. And obviously when we head up to the countryside in Cheltenham, it's fantastic.
What's the biggest change from player to coach now?
As a player, I was definitely more relaxed. I think as a coach, you're like living everyone else's stresses, and you feel as though you want to take on everyone's anxiety and kind of bottle it because you're not out there. But certainly as a player, I was really trusted my ability on the pitch and I never felt too fazed. So probably more of a nervous coach watching than a player.
And last one word to describe your coaching style.
Intimate,
there you go. I look forward to playing with you at some point. Gloucestershire's opponents to start this campaign are Essex, the 2023 runners-up. They eventually lost to champion Somerset. Let's remind ourselves of that final at Edgbaston.
played really, really well against Hampshire, Critch and Harmy at the end there to get us over the line.
He's done it every over so far. It is slower ball, take a punt, pop it downtown and say thank you very much. Slower ball, punished, all the way, that's it. Simon Harmer, the skipper, he takes Essex back to the finals of the Vitality Blast.
So to win how we did, we felt like we had some really good momentum going into that final.
It does hurt when you lose a final and you work so hard. Drawing on that emotion from previous years really helped us.
Two exceptional bowlers come out and set the tone for them, put us under pressure.
Both overseas, Matt Henry and Ishodi were unbelievable. A massive part in us winning that final.
Down the wicket again. Gone, is it gone? Oh my goodness. What a catch that is. He's absolutely crunched it. It's the new man, Casey Aldridge.
I took a couple of steps to my left just because I saw it come in so quick and Rossington was sliding it off the back quite well. So yeah, I felt pretty good after the catch. Don't remember much about the catch.
From the sidelines, it was probably a bit more nerve-wracking than being out there. But once TKC took that catch, the emotions just flowed out everywhere, and it was an amazing feeling.
That's over. No, what a catch! What a spectacular catch! And what a way to finish off Vitality Blast final!
Yeah, never in doubt. He's always catching it.
It's always a show coming to Edgbaston, especially for finals day. The Hollies had a whole day of enjoying themselves and that party atmosphere. So I always love coming here and playing in finals day, and it's to get here is an achievement, I think, every year with the quality that's in the Vitality Blast.
See, long, tough competition, and to miss out after getting so close was obviously gutting, but I think credit to Somerset. I think overall they definitely deserved to win the competition. They were pretty strong throughout.
Winning it like that as well, it wasn't so much pressure relieved, it was just been ecstatic for the boys.
Into the top tier.
It's an excellent catch. Two hands, easy as you like.
Tied up to now. Oh, big shot, big shot. Shot at the nut so far. I don't think he's ever hit the ball further in his life.
Right, it's time for a game of Winner Stays On. I'm here with
Jack.
Jack, love the shirt.
Thank you very much.
I'm here with Gloucester fan Caroline. What on earth is going on here? It's like final day at school, isn't it?
Half Chelsea, half Tottenham.
I prefer Jack's shirt, I'm not going to lie.
Okay.
But we'll see if your answers are different. We're going to have a game of Winner Stays On, so I'll give you two players. You pick one in their prime. We'll get to the end and see who the winner is.
Okie doke.
Jack's shirt or your shirt?
My shirt.
Okay, we'll forget that. Luke Wright or Wayne Madsen?
Wayne Madsen, obviously.
Oh, nice. Wayne Madsen or David Milan?
David Milan, I say.
David Milan or Alex Hales?
Alex Hales.
Alex Hales or James Vince?
I'm having Hales again.
Alex Hales or Ravi Vapara?
I'm sticking with Hales.
Sticking with Hales. Alex Hales or Will Jacks?
Will Jacks.
Will Jacks, we've got to change. Will Jacks or Jason Roy? They can both hit it.
Ooh, gosh, that's a tough one. Jason Roy. I'd have to go for Jason Roy.
Jason Roy or Moeen Ali?
Moeen Ali.
Moeen Ali or David Willey?
David Willey, I think. Yeah, David Willey.
David Willey or Samit Patel?
David Willey.
Yeah. The shirt's the winner.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
The shirt wins.
Yeah, the show wins. I've got it.
Go Gloss.
Well, match night is well underway here in Bristol, but coming up we'll be in Birmingham and Sussex as we continue our journey around the counties. So we're talking rituals with Jack Carson, John Simpson and Tymal Mills. Your ritual in the Blast, how has it evolved over time?
I'd say routine is probably, it's definitely gotten shorter, and I went through a period where I was really paranoid about my body, and I've had a lot of injuries, and I was doing big long warm-ups and things like that, but the last few years I've been, you know, touch wood, I've been pretty good, so I've just got into a bit more of a succinct routine.
Before I bat, I always have a little routine with the physio where he gives me a piece of advice before a bat. It's always the same. He just tells me that it's good old cliche, fairly and straight, and gotten down the ball. So John Boyles gives me that.
John Boyles never played a drop of cricket in his life either as well. So
he just gives me that.
I'm a bit the opposite to T. Even though I like to get to ground early, I like to do everything later.
Play it late, arrive late. Yeah. Nice and early.
Exactly.
That's a nice mix.
Yeah.
I've also got two kids as well, so I'm desperate to get out of the house at any point of the afternoon.
But I'm good in a kicker boot.
You're a good keeper by the looks of it. Big boot.
Yeah, I've got the old side one.
The sidewinder, yeah. How's John's touch?
Yeah, John Boy. his nickname's Chopper.
Yeah.
From back when he's a penny, he's just fucking like.
Northern Ireland.
I think I'd play like centre half.
Yeah.
Like Lewis Dunk. Kind of good on it. And got a nasty streak. Oh, there you go.
He's good, isn't he? He's pretty tidy. Tymal, is there anything you have to do when you're bowling?
I've obviously got that hop, skip, little hop, skip and a jump at the start of my run-up. That firstly came about because I was injured and I struggled with my knee and I couldn't push off. Like it hurt to accelerate. Once I got running, it was okay, but I physically struggled to accelerate. So I found I had to do a little hop to kind of get going. And then obviously my knee got better, but the hop was then ingrained thing. But I always take a second, at the top of my mark, just to set myself, make sure I'm happy with the field, make sure I'm happy with what ball I'm going to bowl, and then, little hop, skip and a jump, and away we go.
Just topping up, just keeping sharp more than anything. Because at 35 I've sort of gone through the whole technical stuff to a base level. Now it's just topping up and making sure everything's in tip-top order, ready to go Friday, really.
Food and drink before a match, after a match, what do you, is it the same thing?
Breakfast at home normally, or ideally drop the kids in nursery and then go out for breakfast. Yeah, we've got a lot of good breakfast and brunch spots here in Hobart. Very, very lucky for that. Nice chorizo eggs down at the spot. Bake down at the bottom is always a favourite.
We get our plugs in every time.
Yeah, bake, yeah. Hook the boys up. We need some free, we need some more freebies.
Yeah. Gotta be rituals for the hair, the skin routine.
Can't you see? I've put a lot of time and effort into this.
It depends. If you're on TV, if you're on playing a TV game on Sky, there'll be some fresh haircuts for the boys. Obviously, I'm a DIY job.
Well, Jack, John, thank you. And if you want chorizo or a selfie with Tymal, 9:30 a.m. in Hove on a match day. Good to see you guys.
Cheers,
good luck.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, Max. Good to see you.
Good to see you guys.
And dusted again for another year, 2023 champion, Lanky the Giraffe.
Camera's on straight away.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter then, does it? It matters what I go on and do now. So we are at the home of finals day, Edgbaston. Our player to watch today is Jacob Bethel. I've asked him so many times already what to call him. So what are we going for today?
I think we're going with Beth.
Beth?
Yeah.
Okay, we're good friends then. So Beth, let's go all the way back. You came to Warwickshire when you were 12, but there's a long story before that. Where did you start playing cricket and why?
Yeah, so I was started in Barbados and just kind of grew up, kind of always had a bat and ball in my hand. Parents tell me that I was throwing fruit around the kitchen and all that kind of stuff.
Made the move to sunny Birmingham when you were 12.
Yeah, not too bad today.
How did that all come about?
It just kind of happened by chance. I was playing over in Barbados and a couple of people saw me from over in England from touring teams. And then kind of within a few months, I was over here looking at schools. I did a lot of travelling by myself and all that because I didn't really have the support network over here, but kind of just got on with it, which is like, looking back on it, was quite just good for my develop in general.
Ian Bell described you as the best 17-year-old he'd ever seen. Do you remember him saying that, and what did that mean to you?
I remember it coming out in an article, but Yeah, it's obviously unreal to have someone of that caliber say that about me, but I've not really taken it too far. Yeah, I could be the best 17-year-old he's ever seen, but it doesn't really matter then, does it? It matters what I go on and do now, so that's kind of the aim I've got.
Don't like that. Don't like that, but it's a wicket. Why use the surface when you can bowl a loopy full toss? Use the biggest boundary and get another wicket.
What do you remember about your Blast debut, 2021?
Yeah, up in Durham, Ben Stokes. Didn't go so well with the ball, and I was meant to be a spinner, but I think I bowled 2 overs for 17 or something like that. But then faced my first ball in professional cricket against Stokesy, which was cool. Yeah, I didn't get many runs either, so it wasn't really a massive game in terms of performance, but it was cool.
When you walk around Edgbaston, even now, do you still get that buzz?
Yeah, it's so weird, like seeing it empty. We train with it 90% of the time empty, and then when it comes to that game day and it's full, it's unreal.
To play here at finals day, that's the goal, right? How good would that be?
That's the aim. Yeah, that would be unreal. That's the aim this year, and it has been our aim the last couple of years. We've got kind of 3/4 of the way there, and then messed it up in the quarterfinals. But we're looking to go one step further.
This is where you roll the tape, because we've got to show you Jake's, I should say, best catch against Yorkshire last season. I think it was Yatesy that was next to you. Just couldn't believe that you made that catch.
Yeah, Yatesy was out of the wicket, I think. He picked me up. Yeah, to be honest, it's a bit of a blur. Stuck out a hand and it stuck. But yeah, it was pretty cool to do it in front of the Western Terrace. Shame it wasn't on Sky, because the coverage would have been better of it.
What are your goals for the Blast this season, personally?
Personally, it's one of them cliche things, like have an impact, a middle order batter. It's just, you're coming in a lot of different situations. Just have an impact, whatever I can do. It's probably going to be rebuilding at stages and then firing us over the line at the end at times. So just kind of have an impact in whatever game I can, and as many times as possible.
And the question everybody wants me to ask, how many different haircuts are we going to see this season?
Well, I've had 2 already. So I maybe could squeeze one more in there. Maybe I've actually had a bet with someone that if we do get to finals day, I'll be going blue and yellow down either side. So that could be my 3rd one.
There you go, Bears fans. There's your reason to hope for finals day.
Well, I hope everyone enjoyed our first Friday Night Blast show. Delighted to say, with this backdrop, David Payne, the first Gloucestershire player of the match this season. This is what it's all about, right? The Blast is back, the weather's great.
Yeah, and the crowd was in. Like you say, we had the sunset in the background. It was a pretty perfect evening, and obviously topped off with a win for Gloucester.
What can we look forward to this season, not just from you guys, but the Blast in general?
Oh, I think with the modern way, I think there's going to be a lot of sixes in there, and hopefully a lot of wickets as well. I think it's just going to be as entertaining as ever, and it's just getting better and better. I mean, it's getting tougher as a bowler because the batters are getting better, but no, it's a great format to play, and like I say, it's the most fun, I think.
Yeah, thanks for joining us. We'll see you again next week. David, would you like to say thanks for watching Friday Night Blast to the camera, please?
Thank you all for watching Friday Night Blast.
See you next week.